more about Prince Harry and his wife Meghan's surprise announcement to step back from their royal duties. Prince Harry defied the Queen when he revealed his plans to pull back from the monarchy. And the Queen said that she'd asked her grandson not to issue Wednesday's public statement, but he went ahead with it anyway. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex say they're working towards being financially independent. That move's dominated the British media. The royal couple are also debuting brand. They're also debuting new branding to further distinguish themselves. So they've applied to trademark Sussex Royal. The copyright would cover everything from this updated website, which you can see on the other side of the screen, to their charity work and social programs. Shola Moshogbamimu is a lawyer and political and women's rights activist, and she joins me for today's royal debrief. Great to have you on the program.
Hello.
Now, we've been having a look at all of the headlines here in Britain. One says Queen's furious, Harry and Meghan say we quit. Mirror saying they didn't tell the Queen. How do you see this? Do you see this as them being courageous captains of their own fate, or are they being petulant and derelicting their duty?
I applaud them. I think that they've made the absolute right decision. It was clear that the unprecedented abuse of vitriol of hate steeped in misogyny, racism and sexism that has been experienced has actually made their position or their duties as senior royals untenable. So something had to give. And this decision is absolutely right for their mental health, their well-being as a family, for their young son. So I applaud them for making this momentous decision. It's the right thing to do.
How significant has the vitriol been lately? Because many people in the press, perhaps unsurprisingly, have argued, actually, the press coverage was quite fair. There was a rough time given to both of them at the beginning, plenty of unpleasant and racist things said about Meghan's background, but that the press coverage had been favourable in large part too.
I don't know what press you've been reading, but there's nothing favourable towards Harry and Meghan. And even if you look at the last 6 months, just a few months ago, both of them made such powerful statements. Harry said, "I will not play the game that killed my mother." Meghan said, "Not many people have asked if I'm okay." That does not sound like they're responding to some fair press. There's not been any fair press. Within days of Meghan giving birth to their son, their son was referred to or compared to a chimpanzee. And the BBC host that made that comment and posted that tweet was fired and then hired back a couple of months later. There's no real accountability. The media has not been fair to them.
I mean, there are obviously individuals who've done deeply racist and hurtful things. But if we think about Meghan's statement that she made in that documentary which you refer to, where she said that she was struggling, essentially, what would you say when people might argue that even though you could celebrate the fact that they're trying to look after their well-being and their own happiness, that actually when you're part of the royal family, that does mean that in order to take on that responsibility and that platform, you have to make some sacrifices. The British stiff upper lip.
Well, I've got some news for the British people. Right, the royal family are not chattel. They're not property because taxpayers' money are used to, you know, pay for their accommodation or pay income to them. They're no different from you and I. If they're indeed employees and we're their employers, that does not mean they don't have a right to privacy. It does not mean they should be put on some pedestal and suffer abuse. Bottom line is this, for all those who need to hear it, Harry and Meghan don't owe the United Kingdom jack all about their own personal lives. They can make their own decisions. And let's bear in mind that there is nothing they have done in their duty as royal, senior royals that has brought the royal institution into disrepute. They've not done that. Mm-hmm. Prince Andrew has. He has been alleged to commit rape. He's had sex with a minor. He's made a decision, or he made the decision, to be friends with a convicted pedophile. That is disgraceful. That is shameful. That is disappointing. Not Harry and Meghan deciding, you know what? We want to redefine our own boundaries. We want to be able to go out there in the world and live a life that means something truly important for us and for their son. I think that is right to do. And it's, let's not forget, this is 2020. This is the 21st century. Women like you and I and Meghan should have the right to decide for ourselves what quality of life we want. We should not be, you know, criticized harshly because we want to do something that is different from the cuff. And I think that it's important that we stop criticizing Meghan for things that other royals are praised for.
And indeed, there is an incredibly stark contrast between what we've seen with Prince Andrew and then how the media have treated Harry and Meghan. But you do raise a point about they owe the British public nothing.
Correct.
And they haven't brought the institution into disrepute. But if we look at their behaviour, for example, excluding the Queen from this decision-making, they did get into trouble over ostensible hypocrisy, saying that people shouldn't fly and then taking private jets. Some issues over using the press occasionally, but not others. My question is, when they say on their website that they want to be members of the royal family with financial independence, are there not inherent contradictions here that they haven't acknowledged? Because they want some of the perks, but then not the difficulties that sometimes are deeply unfortunate, do go along with that territory.
So I would interpret that differently. Mm. I think whether you like it or not, you, me, or anybody else, Harry will always be a member of the family, of the royal family. Mm. So will Meghan because she's his wife, right? Now, by seemingly as though they have, offended the Queen, we don't know that. I'll take that with a pinch of salt. We don't know that for a fact. I think people are making more out of that than there is. I don't believe for a second that people in the palace or the key people were not aware that this message was not going to go out. I'm sure that all of this was, there's no doubt that Harry and Meghan I had to make a momentous decision. Mm-hmm. And when you talk about things like the decisions they've made or the hypocrisy, I don't see them being hypocrites. Mm-hmm. There are many people who support climate change who take planes, and we have to take planes. Technology is not caught up with climate change yet. So to call them hypocrites for doing that is, again, being a hypocrite, because we all care about climate change, but we all get on planes too because it's necessary or for time reasons to do so. So, no, I don't see them being hypocrites. I do think that you do raise a fair point that there are probably going to be complexities and gray shades in I'm still a royal member, but I want to have financial independence.
Yeah.
But again, like anything in life, this is something they're going to have to navigate. All I have to say is this. Give them a chance, for goodness sake. And if you can't, leave them alone.